just wanted to give you a quick breakdown of my brush presets, kind of how I use those and how to install them. So if you're not familiar with the Photoshop tool presets, all you got to do is open up Photoshop, go to Window, Tool Presets, and that's going to open up this window over here. This is your tool preset window, and then you just go to this little menu right here, open this up, go to Load Tool Presets, and then just grab the file that I gave you, the Harrington Painting Brush Set 2020 Final 2. And that should then hit Load as Tools. Don't hit Load as Brushes, but Load as Tools. And that'll give you all my brushes over here on the left-hand panel. And the reason I like to have it as tool presets as opposed to the brush menu, which would be up here, is that it's really easy to grab these and just like switch on the fly. And then it's also giving you the written description of what each one is. And it has all the tool presets, all the options within the brush saved. So you can't break it. If you end up changing some options, you just click it again and it goes back and it'll fix itself. So that's pretty cool. That's why I like to use tool presets as opposed to brush presets. Cool. So I'm just going to quickly go through a couple of these that I use a lot. I'm not going to go through every single one, but I'll try to get through a few of these. They're kind of broken into several different categories. The first one being like my drawing brushes. These are pretty like basic, natural kind of drawing brushes that I use for just kind of everyday sketching and stuff. And if you zoom in, you can kind of see the types of textures that these have. It's trying to emulate some kind of like classical pencil texture that you might see. Like a traditional drawing or something, and that just gives a little more realism to your line work if you're doing something like that. The different versions are just different kind of textures or intensities of textures, so you can mess around with which ones which of those. Those are pretty cool. The next general set, there's also one here called No Texture if you want to have no texture on it. That one's cool if you want more of a synthetic look, so that's pretty cool. The next kind of general set are these basic two here, the round and the square. I have the dates of kind of when I've created these on there. That's what these dates refer to. As you can see, 2018, I've been using this for quite a while, but these are tried and true brushes, so I know they work because I've been using them forever. But essentially, the basic round and the basic square are my pretty much go-to for any type of basic painting. So if I'm gonna like, you know, paint this guy's armor, I'll use something like the basic round to just kind of like do my rendering or any type of like soft painting. Works pretty well. So you can see it's just a really basic round brush, nothing fancy about it, but it's got a little bit of like a opacity pressure sensitivity on there. So you can really get some nice painterly properties with it, which is cool. The square is essentially the same one, but you can see it rotates. You can see me rotating as I rotate my pen. So that'll rotate as you get into little pieces here. So it's really good for like kind of sci-fi stuff or anything with hard edges. You can get a really nice hard edge with that. So anything that has like a hard surface to it, this is great for, you know, sci-fi or armor, that kind of thing. That's one of my go-to brushes. Those two are my main rendering brushes. So if I'm rendering anything, I'll definitely be using the Harrington Round and the Harrington Square. And they're very simple brushes, but they've been kind of like customized so that they do exactly what I want them to do, and they're, you know, they have the exact type of pressure sensitivity that I want in there, which is pretty cool. So if you've never used a brush with that kind of pressure sensitivity to it, or that kind of angle tilt to it, it's a lot of fun. So I'd suggest trying that out. Cool, the next section of brushes here are the line brushes. And these are fairly simple, but they're really good for sci-fi stuff. So actually I did this whole painting with these three line brushes. What it is they're just really basic brushes, but they have a tilt to them. So if I'll pick red, see, it's really obvious. So you can see that they're just like a line, and they're a varying length. So we've got the longer one, it's a little bit longer. So, And then there's the longest one. It's like extremely long. It's very, you have to make it pretty big to even see it. But the good thing about these is you can use it as like a tool to kind of do these kind of sci-fi elements. So if I want to add some like antennas over here or like a ladder, some pipes or something, it's a really cool way to just kind of do that really fast. But yeah, when I was doing this for like a lot of these straight lines, I just used the line, this line brush to kind of make some quick lines in there. And it's kind of a drawing brush and a painting brush. So you can kind of use it to make these really straight lines across the edge of something like that, which is pretty cool. And I found these to be really useful with sci-fi type of stuff. It's great. Yeah, that's the line brushes. Those are pretty cool. And yeah, anything like a grid, like if you want to lay down a quick perspective grid, something like this, these are pretty cool for that. So that's pretty neat. So the next section is these texture painting brushes. These ones are really cool because if you're doing any kind of like landscape, you can apply a lot of texture with these brushes. There's a couple different ones in here of varying different textures. But you can see, like, just with this one brush stroke, how much texture is in that brush. And you can use it for character stuff, you can use it for landscape stuff. I used to find it really useful for just landscape stuff, but more recently I've been using it for more character stuff because it's a pretty cool way to add a lot more kind of like texture to your character work. And if I go back to my landscape here, like if I just kind of start painting with it, like if I wanted to make this dirt instead of metallic surface, it's just a cool way to quickly and painterly put some texture down. And without a whole lot of effort, you can kind of imply a lot more detail than you're actually painting because the brush has so much detail in it. And it's just a canvas texture, so it can kind of fool your audience into thinking that it's some kind of traditional painting or something that's not entirely defined. I found that to be really helpful when you're doing something really fast. So now that's kind of like a more organic kind of area as opposed to something metallic down there. So that's cool. So that's a good one. Got a couple in here that are really kind of like hard, but basically they're hard-edged on one side and softer-edged on the other side, and it has a point to it, so you can kind of tilt and use the hard edge where you want it and kind of use it very tactically. And that's it. These are really cool brushes. These are the point brushes. Those are pretty neat. I have a couple of these that are have a canvas texture in them too. So if you zoom in, you can kind of see like how much grungy texture is in there. And you can use that texture a lot to imply a lot more detail than it's actually in there. So if like you want to add like some ropes or some pipes or something there, because it's more of a sci-fi thing. It's a cool way to do that. If you want to add some texture, just use it more lightly. You can apply some texture in there because it's got that nice texture in it. That's pretty cool. Couple more canvas brushes. So I've got some canvas brushes that are a little more subtle. And then I've got a few in here that are a little more heavy. So, and you can see these all have custom pressure sensitivity to them. So you can brush them in very lightly, or you can use them pretty heavy. If I go back to my kind of landscape area here, you can see that if you just kind of imply these areas, you can get a lot of mileage out of these. But not really defining a whole lot, but kind of just implying certain things. So that's cool. Yeah, so it's a couple different variations of that. Couple texture buildup brushes if you just want something really gnarly. So sometimes I want a texture, but I won't just like go in straight. I'll add like a an overlay layer, and then I can add my texture on top. And then I can change the opacity of the layer and get some nice textures in there. You can kind of see like how that works. You can make it not so obvious, and you can erase out certain parts of it. But that's a cool way to use some of these texture brushes that I have in there. Those are cool. Going down the list, a couple different drawing brushes in there. So these are the ones similar to the ones that are, or these are older, a little bit older brushes, but they're a couple different ones in there, different shapes and sizes you can experiment with. Pretty cool. This brush is called the Sci-Fi Block. This one's cool for just like a really hard edge, some really hard edge stuff if you're doing like sci-fi stuff. That's cool. And then some different airbrushes in here. These are always useful for making more soft transitions and clouds and, you know, that kind of stuff. Cool. And then there's a couple of mixer brushes in here too. So the mixer brushes, if you uncheck this box right here, this is current tool only. This will allow you to see all the brushes I have in here. So the mixer brushes are cool because they're a cool way to blend. Like most of my mixer brushes are blenders. And the way I've constructed these blenders is that they actually add texture as you're blending, as opposed to the smear brush or smudge brush, which will just remove texture. And that's not what you want when you paint. You actually want, in traditional painting, you have a canvas or some, or paper or wood or some type of texture that you're painting on. And when you blend things, you get that texture coming through as you mix things together. So a couple of these blenders I have in here are pretty cool. So I've got some canvas blenders, various different textures. These work really well on the sci-fi stuff, your, or on the character stuff. So I'll use the character example because it's probably a little more obvious. So you can see how this blender has a nice canvas texture underneath. So as I blend the sphere, it picks up that texture underneath, and that's cool. I've got a palette knife, or a couple of palette knives in here. And by palette knife, I mean it's like a brush that will scrape across the surface of something. And I've got various intensities in here. So in traditional painting, a lot of times you'll do this scraping technique to kind of imply directionality to something, or, you know, blur out an edge or kind of soften an edge. And I've got a couple different strengths in here and a couple different textures with the palette knife. So I've got like a canvas texture, like a weave texture. Some of these are pretty strong, so you can really get like some wild, you know, if you want to make a really wild painting, you can get pretty crazy with some of these. But they're really powerful. You can do a lot of stuff with this stuff, with these brushes. I've got some ones that are a little more fine textures. So if you zoom in here, you can see like it's a pretty fine texture in there. It's pretty cool. I'm gonna do this because it looks like a mess. I apologize for my sloppiness. But part of painting is being sloppy, so that's good. And then I've got some palette knives that have more of a broader texture in there. But these are a lot of fun. You can really go to town with these. Some paper textures ones in there too. But the cool thing about these is you can really smudge the paint around, really get some wild effects. And a lot of times you can actually imply a lot of lost edges with these kind of palette knife brushes, and the painting will just work, which is kind of cool. This is more of a heavier texture blender, and then this one that I use a lot is the noise blender. So this is something that's like a really soft blend. So if you're doing like a really smooth surface, let's find a smooth surface here. So like say this guy's shoulder pauldron here, it's kind of a smooth surface. I can really smooth that out with this noise blender. It has a nice kind of diffusion to it. So if I take something that's a little heavier, like a big highlight or something, my round brush, I can use this noise blender to kind of diffuse that highlight out a little bit. So it's not quite so hot. So that's a good one. I use this one quite a bit because it's something you use for like refining like a final illustration a lot, and then kind of like blurring an edge here, kind of softening some elements into the background or adding some like fog. It's pretty cool for that kind of thing. Cool. That's pretty much it. That's most of the brushes, at least most of the brush categories. There's a couple fun things in here that I added that are just kind of some ideas to play with, some shapes, like a really crazy tech pattern. Add a color. So if you want to add a really crazy tech pattern or something, could be fun. Or some repeating windows. Just some things to kind of think about that you can do. Like if you were to fill this, it could be kind of a cool thing. If you wanted to add like a tech panel to this guy or something, it could be kind of neat. That's just some fun stuff to mess with. If you're in the mood to try some more experimental stuff, that's some things to play with. Those are just in the shapes category up here. But yeah, so that's most of the stuff. As far as like the ones I use the most, again, it's gonna be the these two round and square brushes. Those are gonna be the ones that are the go-to. So that's the round. That's the square. Then the lines brushes, and the texture brushes. Texture paint brushes, and of course the blenders. Those are always good. So yeah, so I hope you enjoy these. I've got a whole series of tutorials about how to paint all this stuff if you're interested as well. But just messing around with these brushes and having some fun with them should get you started. And yeah, so hope you enjoy them and get a lot of use out of them. So awesome. Take care, guys.